in orchestras. It's best to go on the other here. Make sure you got label objects ticked, exclude objects ticked. Leave that as it is. So just those two ticked there. On the others, okay. You'll probably hear my printer starting up, starting these 10 of them discs. I know I've got brims on. I just wanted to show you. If you're looking to exclude objects, say one isn't coming up right, just go up here, click on there, and then you've got the file name, I think, there, my file name, they're all clones and all the same. Click on that, exclude objects. Now it won't print out that one. I'll show you that. It's just starting to print now. Ask for Grim. Let's see if it does 10. It should only do 9 because it should exclude the one I've asked to exclude. Now, yes, you can do this part way through the print. See if you've got 10 to, however many. Let's say 10 like I'm trying to do here. Objects, especially a bit taller than the test piece. If something happens to that, it might get dragged or knocked over onto your other parts and cause them to be damaged. I don't think it's doing it. I would have thought I'd do this one than that one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think it's already doing it. So it's 7. Behind the set, this is 8. Now what's going to happen with the 9? Let's finish that one off. Starting on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and it should miss 10 off. So imagine these are taller objects, and say that one fell over something. There was an error in it. She's missed that part off. That's just the grim, all that. So this is the part itself. Yeah, this power pan is on there. But you can see it's stick that it's extruded that part. Now it could be in the middle of the bed, obviously. It doesn't have to be like in that corner. But I paused the video just now, but let's do that and get that. Yeah, that should finish. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And missed number 10 off, which I asked it to exclude using that option I showed you. These are just like a test disc on the inside and a big rim on the outside. Just cause